Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will talk about IR spectroscopy of carbonyl compounds, which is one of the key applications of IR in organic chemistry. This video features signals from CO double bonds, carbonyls. I want to highlight five different functional groups: aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids, esters, and amides. These are all carbonyl groups, and carbonyl stretches tend to be very prominent signals in any IR spectrum. Okay, where does an aldehyde carbonyl stretch appear in an IR spectrum? That would be about 1710 wave numbers. All right, how about ketones? Again, 1710. Acids, 1710. Esters, these are a bit different. They generally appear at 1740 wave numbers or so. Amides are also different. They normally appear in the high 1600s. You might see a challenge here. If you have a nice strong absorbance at 1710 wave numbers, you might know you have a carbonyl, but how do you know if you have an aldehyde, ketone, or carboxylic acid? As it turns out, this is fairly easy because these functional groups have other features. So for an aldehyde, yes, you will have a carbonyl stretch at 1710. You will also see the CH stretches that are specific for aldehydes. The CH stretch in aldehydes appears as two signals, one around 2700 and another around 2800. If you see a signal at 1710 and don't have these two signals as well, then you do not have an aldehyde. How about carboxylic acids? Yes, you will see an absorbance at 1710. You will also see the OH stretch. This will be a very strong, very broad signal down past 3200 wave numbers. What is special about ketones? Nothing. Ketones do not have any other signals. If you have a signal at 1710, but no special CH signals like the aldehyde and no large OH from an acid, then you have a ketone. Esters and amides are also distinctive. Esters often show a CO stretch, strong CO stretch, in the range of 1200 or lower. You may even see two signals. Amides, if they have an NH, will show an NH stretch near 3200 wave numbers. Are there other factors to consider? Of course. The values on the previous slide are general locations, but the structure of the molecule can affect the position of the absorption. Let's discuss two structural features. The first is a ring. Cyclohexanone shows up at about 1715, which is fairly typical of all ketones. Cyclic ketones with ring strain tend to move to a higher position. Cyclopentanone is at 1750. Cyclobutanone is at 1775. Another factor is resonance and conjugation. So here is cyclohexanone. The carbonyl stretch is around 1715. If you put a double bond in the ring to make an unsaturated ketone, the signal moves to 1691 wave numbers. This shift decreases because of resonance. The electron density in the additional conjugated alkene allows additional resonance forms. So we can swing the alkene up and break the carbonyl. The carbonyl now has more CO single bond character. That makes the CO bond strength weaker. It takes less energy to stretch the CO bond, and the position of the absorbance moves to a lower wave number value. So the message here is that positions of absorbances are not fixed. Every molecule is different and may have small variances in terms of the position of the signal. Regardless, the guidelines that we see in these slides are representative of typical values that you see across most organic molecules. Furthermore, the typical values are quite predictable. That was a quick summary of IR signals from carbonyl functional groups. I hope you have a better understanding of this topic. As always, questions are always welcome in the comments section. Take care.